Hello everyone, my name is Jazz and I'm part of Escape Studios. Today we'll be going through a run cycle animation tutorial with you. The tutorial will be broken down into a few separate stages. These stages will be, the first stage will be the run cycle reference we'll look at. The second stage will be blocking out the poses for the run cycle. And the third stage will be moving from blocking into spline. The tutorial will show you a three-step run cycle, and at the end of that we'll add a infinity curve, which will just give you a nice constant loop animation going through all the steps. Okay, so let's begin by looking at the run cycle reference. So I was going to bring up a couple of YouTube videos, and we'll go through the actual steps for the run cycle. Okay, so the first video, let's play it from the start, gives you a reference of the steps taken to complete the actual run cycle itself. Now, in a previous class you've done a walk cycle, and the difference between a walk cycle and a run cycle is at one stage both feet will actually be lift off the ground compared to the walk where there's always 1 foot planted. Now, as you see here, let's go play this again. As you see here, you see the back leg always pushes off and the front leg will always plant down quickly. You also see that half the body is always on the front leg and half is on the back leg. This gives you better balance and shows weight in your animation as well. Okay, let's have a quick look at the second video. This one is the same video from the front view. Now this gives you a bit more reference into the hips area, gives you the full rotation. As each step goes down, you'll notice that the weight is transferred onto that foot. So just this side, and then when it goes on this side, more weight here. And as it slowly shifts back and forth. And we'll put those rotations in the body of our rig to give you a bit more realistic animation as well. These links that are from my from the video reference I've chosen will also be placed in the tutorial at the bottom. And we'll be using this to help with blocking out the poses. So what we can do is compare these to the blocking I've already done. So let's bring the Maya scene up. Pause this. Bring the Maya up. Okay. So it's always good to see where I'm getting the reference from and how I'm actually creating the poses. So the first step is the first contact pose, which is here. And this is when the first time the foot actually lands. Then we get the second one, which brings you to the down pose. So this is the most lowest pose there is. You'll notice that this back leg gives a bit more overlap. And as you're going to go through this animation, you'll see the back leg swings all the way through and then lands. The other foot stays planted from here. And as you're going through the animation, you'll notice that it begins to push off. And this last pose is when you're showing full exaggeration of the amount of energy and inertia that you need to push off from this foot to leap and then land on that one. So this one, it shows this pose, the lowest point. Then you got the beginning to pass through, which is here. Then you got the next pose when you're halfway through swinging your foot through. And you got a little bit of lift from here as well. And I've got it here where the half the foot is planted, the toes part, and the heels off the ground. Next part. Is this the highest point? This is the highest point here. that goes to this point. As you notice that this leg is fully straight, but this one I've given a slight bend. You can't have actually have it as a fully straight leg. When you're playing the animation through, it'll give you like a little flick in the leg, you know, like a little glitch. So you don't want that. What you want is a slight bend. So when you are playing the animation through, it looks more realistic. So you have a slight bend here, you're pushing off. Then we've got the next pose, which will be in midair, slightly less than the highest point. So let's go to that one, which is that. The back leg is still hanging back a little bit, and it's getting ready to land. I put a curve in the foot, similar to this one. And then the last pose is where the foot actually lands again. What I've also done in the body is put a rotation. So from this aspect, you'll see the body has the weight on this leg. On the very first pose, the body is rotated around to have more weight on this leg. So when you're going back and forth, you're showing a bit more realistic animation. We saw that in the video where you're looking at from the front, which is this one. Again, going back here, you see the weight on his leg transfers back on that. And you'll see here, you see like a motion of going back and forth, back and forth. Okay, so the next stage, we'll be going through the actual blocking. We'll talk about each pose in a bit more detail. We'll talk about making sure that half the body is over the planted foot to show balance and the weight shift. And we'll look at how the foot placement comes down quickly to give more weight. Okay, so we're gonna go through the second stage now, and this will be the actual blocking part. I've imported the Ultimate Walker rig. This is the same rig you'd use for your walk cycle. And this is now shown in the four perspective views. We're mainly working from the side and the front view to do all the poses. But I just wanted to quickly show you, I'll start with this one, let's go to this screen. What I always do is I start off by moving the body slightly forward, and then I highlight each the foot parts and push that forward as well. I really use very rarely do I use this controller. This actually controls the whole body part. If you animate anything from here, it will actually distort in your animations from here and it won't look realistic. Okay. You have one controller for your left leg, and we'll be using the foot roll and the toe roll itself, and we'll be using the rotation tool as well for the to move the feet around. To move the body, for this specific tutorial, we'll be using the move tool, moving forward and back. We might need to go up and down, and the top controller is your squash and stretch. So when we're going to the up and down poses, we might add a little squash, a little stretch, squash part for the down pose, this one, second one, and when you're going up to the fifth pose, we might add just a little touch there. Now for the poses, we'll be on each frame, so we'll start from frame zero, that'll be the first one, and then each one cycle step takes 7 frames, which is 7 different poses. Cool, so go back out of here. And again, the first pose, which will be the contact pose. So the first pose will be this one. So I'm gonna start off with this leg. Push this forward. body forward as well. Lift his leg up. Now we want to put rotation in this foot to make it like this, and we want to have this foot facing upwards. Now I'll be using the toe roll, and I use middle mouse button and drag it backwards, and use a foot roll. Use the rotation slightly. Keep going back to the pose. It's got a bit more of an angle. Closer to the body. So if I go now to the front, change this panel to back, which shows you the front. So this is now highlight the body. And this part here, as I'm rotating it down, if I go back to this part, so you see this part here, it rotates slightly down that way, then it goes back and it rotates that way. Well, I'll show you for the tutorial will be how I pose the first step and the second step. And the last step, I'll leave that to you guys to do. What I recommend you do is when you are actually modeling or doing any animations for the run cycle, walk cycle, or any kind of locomotion, if you want to do get the real feeling of the rotations in your hips, what I've always been taught is you put a hand either side of each hip, so your left hand and your left hip, right hand and your right hip, and if you were to walk forward, you feel how much rotation actually goes into your hips, and you actually feel the rotations going around and the rhythm as of each step. Another little trick I use is if you press 7 on the keyboard, it turns the lights off. And what this gives you is a good silhouette of your actual poses. What's always recommended to do is not to have too many limbs crossing over each other or be hidden from each other. For example, if you were to have something like this, turn it back on to 5, it looks, you can see what's going on here, but when you're in actual watching an animation, when the limbs are hidden away from each other, you lose a bit of information. So what I always sometimes do is I press 7 on the keyboard and I can position how the pose should be and how it looks as clear as possible. So I've also added, when I first off added the rotation on this side, and now I need to add the rotation going around that way. And as you are, the reason why I put the rotations in with the blocking is because when it comes to spline, and you were in, you didn't put this in your blocking stage, you will lose bit parts of your poses. So right now, if I hadn't done that before, the leg would have looked slightly different when I do come into spline. So if I add the rotations in now, when I do convert from blocking to spline, it will keep as much information as possible, and it will be a lot easier in the spline mode. Because sometimes when you are doing blocking and you move into spline, you can lose a bit of your detail in your blocking. and you have to add that back in. But if you add as much in information as you can in your blocking, when you do go into spline, it's a little bit more easier. So if I were to see from this point of view, so first of all, what I've done is highlight everything except this controller, and I've pressed S to set frame. Now I'm going to go into the side view. Actually, what I can do is go to the top view and show you how much rotation went in there. Y axis. Shows you how much is going in there. I'm just going to take it back out. But it's just a quick overview to show you how much goes in this part and this part as well. Okay, so the first pose is done. Now I'm going to get to the second one. Now this one will be the down pose. So now the foot needs to be planted. So we take away the foot roll to zero, put the toe roll, put that to zero as well. And move the body forward. And bring it down. I'm going to bring the foot down as well. And we're going to take off the rotations from each side. Put a zero. Let's check the silhouette. If we check the silhouette of this pose to this pose, we need to move the foot backwards, so rotate it. We can add some overlap action to that by in the toe roll itself. Five on the keyboard again to bring it back, to put the lights back on. I'll highlight each of the controllers, press S on the keyboard. So see the first foot was here, and now it gets dragged down here. As it's been dragged, the toes slightly come backwards, as it's giving a bit more overlap and action. The next pose will be now the midpoint, which will be this one. So we need to go slightly higher. The foot now is more facing downwards. Now press 7. You can actually see each of the limbs. Highlight everything there. I want to make sure the half the weight is on the front part of the body, on this planted foot. So just slightly move it forward, like so. Actually move a little bit forward. That's that. So go back backwards. So foot swings down, foot slams down on one frame. Now it's beginning to push off. So the third pose will be the actual beginning of the liftoff. Make sure the knee controller is ahead. So now the foot is going to be curved, coming in front now. So the rotations. We can take away the toe roll a little bit as well. Feel free to zoom in and out of the pose as close as you need. So the knee here is slightly lower. Like so. And now we need to have the toes planted still down. So we can do that by going to the toe roll again, push it up, and then we'll go to the foot roll. One thing you need to make sure is you know where the foot was actually the last position. So when you're zooming in, it's just about here. When you rotate it around, normally I use a drawing tool. I'll leave like a little dot, so you can buy a few on-screen markers, and I highly recommend buying those. It's only like between £10 and £20, and allows you to annotate on your animations, make notes, just physically just draw on the screen itself. I'll only place like a dot here and a dot there, just to make sure there's no foot sliding. Just double check the pose again. That one, so it might need a little bit more height. Press 7 on the keyboard. We can put a pose down for that. So here is a foot slide. So the toe was actually about here. As my toe is too far back. So we've gone back to the body on frame one, highlight this part here, and now I'm going to rotate it downwards. Up. Okay, so it gives you a nice contrast from your body going up, shows you the direction where the whole body is moving. To the opposite where it goes down, fully down. Okay. The next pose will be the one where it's actually in midair. That's the difference between the walk cycle and a run cycle. So let's have a look at this one. So now the foot's actually lifted off the air. Feet are quite separate apart, quite balanced apart. This foot is coming down to replace it that way. So now we use the, actually remove the rotation. Actually, sorry, gotta go to the frame 5 first. Rotate to 0. Remove the body forward. Get that foot ready. Go forward, up now. Now, as it's left that previous part, we see there's a bit of rotation and just in the toe roll to give you a bit of overlapping action as well. So we go backwards. the moment, if you put a line down here, more weight is towards the back foot compared to the middle. So we're going to push this forward. Push that right out. Highlight everything and set a keyframe. Actually, we can rotate a little bit higher. This foot. Push this one out a bit more. Next frame will be the actual contact of the other foot, and then we'll add some rotations in the hips again. So that will be this one, frame number 7. Now we're going to go for the contact pose. So I'm going to bring this forward and down a little bit. We add the rotations. The hips, so we'll go into the multi-view section. We'll add the rotation this side, so onto the hips. To bring this leg forward. A little bit higher as well. Put a rotation in. Let's double check that. So now, a nice bend in here. I want to keep that foot straight. Keep that foot straight. So it needs a bit more. We've done the rotations, but we also need to rotate the hip one more time. So we go back into there, highlight this. And I like to use multi-view to see what's actually going on. So now in the y-axis, we're going to rotate it. Cool. So now we go back into this pose. Set a keyframe. So from that pose, you see the rotation going. Let's go into multi-view to get better. To go to this angle, and this one. So if you look back and forth, all the way on one side, all the way on the other side. One thing I need to do, which I forgot to do, was to bring the knee forward. And then the other one as well. Go to keyboard number 7. See how it looks in that one. First highlight, I think. actually a bit more forward compared to that for the first pose we did. Yep, cool. So that's the first step. And now we're gonna do the second step. And that will be again the down and going up and landing. Right, so we'll now do the second step. So first step. And now it's planted. So go to frame 7. And back to, we've done this one, now we go to down pose. So we're gonna flatten these out, put to 0. And the rotation to 0. Bring this down, we'll take the rotations out of the body, 0, put this to 0 as well. What we can do, we can rotate this downwards. Make sure half the weight is on planted leg. Now we need to make sure the heel is exact same location as that. Just slightly out. Go back to these, so foot is fully rotated back on the back leg. Highlight it again, just make sure it matches up to the other one. If you look at the translate, Y is slightly lower, so 1.286. Up there. So you can bring this down. What we can do is when we finish the poses, we'll go into the graph editor. And we'll look at all of the Y translates and we'll make sure it matches up to each step. So this one's going down, and then we'll do another, as you did another step, you'll see all three of those. So we've got a couple of fail-safe systems to look at just to make sure all of the poses are correct and matching up correctly. So for the moment, it's a down pose. Move this to the side. Okay, we want to go to the part into the passing pose. Is rotated flat, so you need to do that as well. rotations out from here as well. So I'm just comparing both the poses. So this one's got a bit of a gap here. Let's push this back a little bit. So frame 9, we're going to go to this pose as it's going up. We need to bring up the foot as well again and make sure the toes are planted down. So for the moment, if we just highlight this one, all the handles, put a keyframe, we'll go back to the other one and see what the foot roll was. So foot roll was 2.1 and the toe roll was minus 67. I think it was. It's actually the wrong one. Just want to make sure where actually is. Highlight everything. Add a bit of curve in the foot as well. So we did a bit of rotation. frame 10, we'll go to the liftoff part. Need to make sure where the toe is. I'll just double checking to make sure the toe is right. That's okay. I can also add in some rotation to the body. Have it going up. Need to bring it down slightly. Okay, looks nice. In frame 11, will be this one in the air again. We'll take out the rotation of the body. Highlight everything and put a keyframe down. So this foot right here seems quite similar to these two. So we need to change it slightly. Let's go back to the reference. So here, what I've done wrong was the foot should have gone up. So at the moment it's too similar to this one. So now I'm going to rotate it a little bit higher. Okay, we'll compare them again. I guess a bit better. The last one will be to the planting foot, which will be this pose. we're going to add the rotations in the body. I'm going to go to the multi view again. Rotate this way. And then rotate on the Y axis. We can take the foot out a little bit longer, make it stretched out. Check it to the first one. See this one, the body's too far back. See, there's a nice silhouette. This one seems to me that it's slightly off. Adjust this a little bit. Okay, so that's that part done. What we need to do now is go over, check all the settings, make sure this pose, the contact pose, has the correct rotations in the R rotate, and in this foot, make sure the foot roll is correct, so the same settings throughout of all the other similar poses to this, and the toe roll as well. And you'll need to go through each contact pose and make sure it's exactly the same. Because this one's slightly different. 23, yes, 18, minus 26, yeah, 2.1. Okay, so what I'm going to quickly do is go through all the settings and make sure it's exactly the same. And then the last stage will be to go to spline. So what I'll quickly show you is the graph editor. What we can do is check the height of each step is exactly the same. So what we do there is we highlight this controller of the body. We go to translate Y. Press F on the keyboard to make sure it's all the same. At the moment it's in stepped. So if I highlight this and I go into spline mode, is this one, you'll notice that one of the steps is higher than the other. So if I was to go on this very first step, and if I then go to, well, let's scroll it down, that's the highest point, that's in the air. Contact point needs to be exact same. So that is minus 11, 72.1. So my fault, it is actually, they will translate Y is minus 0.78. So let's highlight that. Control C, take it back to the first one, and do Control V. Okay, so what I'm going to do is go through these, clean these up, and then the next part will be to do spline, and I'll see you very shortly. So for this part, what I'm doing is fixing the scene a little bit. What I've done is fixed the up and down. So if I go back to here, I went to original pose, which was on 0.0, and I needed to match. Let's take the bar again. I needed that to match the very first pose, which is that one. So I highlighted the value of Y to each pose, to this one, and to this one, to make sure it's matching up. And what I'm going to do now is put in the work of the rotations either side. So for example, in this part, rotation X, for example, what you'll notice here is if I change the angle again. So you see from it rotates to one side, it goes to neutral, and as it takes the next step, it goes back to the other side, rotation that way, and that step. Rotation that way. So we need to do here, we need to take these parts out. So these two can come out. These to come out as well. And these two as well. And this one. So you delete all those frames. So now when you're moving back and forward, a nice smooth motion. So it changes back there, back there. Taking away the other keyframes stops any jerky motion or mechanical motion. This now feels a lot smoother. Now we're going to do the same things to all the other rotations as well. So if I go back to this one, is specifically for when the body facing down, so when it goes to the lowest point, I rotated the body downwards here. And when it comes back up to the highest point, go back. Can rotate this up a little bit. So we're going to fix those parts up now as well. So I've gone back to this view To show you if I do the rotations, how it what part I'm working on. So this is this part. I'll bring the graph editor back in to show you guys. If I'm stepped, we're going to go to auto-spline for the moment. Let's take out. So the highest point is when you take the next step and next step going down. So we can take these parts out because they're on zero at the moment. So if I left it in as well, it would only have the animation looks a bit more mechanical now. So there's no change or weight shift between each step. We need to put that back in. So what I can do is take these out. Take these out again. If you create the extra step, you will have an extra curve here. There we go. Okay, and the last one will be the Y. Let's show you how Y, what happens there. That's the actual twisting of the body. So if you look at this part top here, you can see how it moves in. Let's go to Y, highlight this, go to spline, let's delete these, You want to match up first one to last, so we can find the value of this, copy, find the value of that one, paste, and it's matching. So now but you want to be careful how much you're actually changing of your poses. So let's double check what's going on just to make sure things are okay. So let's okay still. See, that one is too straight now, this leg. So you need to move it slightly forward. Get a bend back in there. Let's put a keyframe there. That's fine. Okay. Yep. Cool. So what I'm going to do is highlight. Spline mode. We can quickly check the animation. Zoom out a little bit. Cool. Now what I've noticed is there's some parts in the Translate Z. Let's highlight all of it again. I don't think all of it was changed. So if I go to Translate Z on the body, press F, highlight this, and I go to Linear. Gives you a little bit more. So I'm going to move this down a bit. So at this frame, it was a little bit pushed out. So it felt like the animation slowed down slightly. Now you get a bit more consistency. So I change this to linear. We've done this axis, done that rotation. That's fine. Okay, so now we're going to go up and down again. We're going to fix that part. Again, you want to make sure each height, it represents the same one. So this height down a little bit. We can delete these two parts, these two again, so this is the highest, let's push off that, so make sure they're the same. Okay, so what I needed to do was, when I matched all the values up, I noticed I had to actually move this slightly forward. Just making sure there's no overshoots. What you want to make sure in your run cycles, you want to have a good up and down. So you got a nice up and down going there. You also got the rotation in the hips. And you got good poses going on, strong poses. One thing I like to do when I'm doing my animations is I like to go backwards and forwards. So if you go backwards now, and you go forwards again, you can make sure there's no animations missing, or foot out of placement, or arms or limbs out of place. If you go backwards and forwards and it's run smoothly, you know you're roughly there. Okay, so what we can do for the final parts, you can even rotate the feet out slightly. So for example, a highlight, if you can't see, highlight this, I'm going to rotate the foot slightly out. And when it contacts on the other side, I hope this tutorial has been helpful, and what I can quickly go over again is the reference. So you see, you feel the up and down. And you feel the push. Watch it again. You feel the push of the momentum of the back leg. So we go back to animation. Which is this one. Let's hide all the nerve curves just for a moment. So you get it up and down as well. And you get the feeling that it's been pushed forward. getting as much tool done for the run cycle. I recommend please check out the references before you actually start blocking and adding the poses in. It gives you a good understanding of the momentum and the actual speed of your animation. Hope this has been useful, and thank you for listening.